You were probably just dreaming, Henry. Didn't they find you asleep on a siding?
I was perfectly awake. I saw a ghostly sailboat sailing along in the moonlight, as if the land was the sea.
Ooh, a ghostly boat, Bill.
That does sound very scary.
Nonsense! That just sounds silly.
Ha! Sounds to me like the Lost Pirate.
The Lost Pirate?
Ah.
Oh, my. But it's true. I saw the Lost Pirate, and he was just like Salty says he was. Emily!
Oh, hi, Reg. What job shall we do next, Edward? Or should I say, best friend?
Best friend? Well, I thought I was your best friend.
Excuse me? I'm Emily's best friend.
You can't be her best friend. I am.
But none of you are. I am.
You're all my best friends?
Well, we can't wait for you to decide now. We're late for the grand unveiling of the sand sculpture.
Sand sculpture? Oh, no!
Thomas and Percy clickety-clacked along the tracks. Kevin rolled and rattled on the flatbed. Their pistons pumped with excitement. First, they told Edward and Henry.
We're coming!
We're with you!
Next, they found Gordon and James.
The Diesels must not get away with this!
We'll stop their trickery with a whoosh and a whish!
Then they found Emily. She was at Brendam Docks.
We won't rest or stop till we've pushed them all out.
But when he puffed into the frosty forest, there was Edward with Henry's lucky trucks.
I've found you!
Henry chuffed excitedly, but he puffed too quickly. His wheels slid on the icy tracks, and he biffed right into his lucky trucks.
Oh no! I've broken my lucky trucks!
Groaned Henry. He sat sadly in the snow.
I'm not going anywhere without my lucky trucks,
huffed Henry. But they're broken, chuffed Edward. And if you don't collect the presents soon, the children won't have anything to open in the morning. Henry thought about how sad the children would be.
I have to get to the airport somehow, puffed Henry, even without my lucky trucks.
Henry was waiting for the visitors with the special train.
Peep, peep!
The fat controller angrily pointed to the clock, but excited passengers cheered and thanked Edward, his driver and fireman. Duck and Boko saw to it that Edward was left in peace. Gordon and James remained respectfully silent.
He chuffed towards Brendam Docks. At a junction, Henry decided to take the track that passed the wishing tree. Henry arrived at the wishing tree. It wasn't standing tall anymore. Some leaves were gone and some branches were broken. Sometimes, Henry, special woodsmen have to cut trees down.
Oh, no.
Now Henry was even more upset. He didn't have enough steam and came to a stop outside Edward's station. Oh dear, thought Henry, I shall have to go away. Oh dear, oh dear. All he could do was to go slowly onto a siding, and Edward took charge of the train. The Fat Controller and Fireman went on discussing Henry's troubles. What do you think is wrong, Fireman? Asked the Fat Controller. Excuse me, sir, he answered, but the fact is the coal is wrong. We've had a poor lot lately, and today it's worse. The other engines can manage, they have big fireboxes. Henry's is small and can't make the heat. With Welsh coal, he'd be a different engine. It's expensive, said the Fat Controller, but Henry must have a fair chance. James shall go and fetch some.
Who's that?
That's Henry. He's a very kind engine, but he's a bit of a worrier. And he doesn't like rain. Once an engine attached to a train was afraid of a few drops of rain. He rushed into a tunnel and squeaked through his funnel and never came out again. His driver and fireman argued with him, but he wouldn't budge. The rain will spoil my lovely green paint and red stripes, he said.
It was a moonlit night and Henry was working with Edward. The big green engine was taking a goods train to the station by the lake. Whenever that owl hoots, a mist rolls in, murmured Edward. There's a legend that when the mist's about, there's a ghost about too. Take care on the old line, Henry. Stupid bird, said Henry. Owls, mists, ghosts. Edward's going soft in the boiler. There's no mist.
Cinders and ashes.
Spencer was being pulled by Edward and shunted by Henry. Slate dust had blocked his funnel. Spencer had to go to the Sodor Steamworks.
As time went on, Edward and Gordon would often pass by. Edward would say, peep, peep, hello. And Gordon would say, poop, poop, poop. Serves you right.
Only me!
Henry? You mean you're the ghost train?
Why didn't you tell us?
I tried to, but you all laughed at me.
I need another engine to take the mail.
Edward could do it, chirruped Emily.
Yes, huffed Henry. Edward knows how to do everything. Good idea, said the Fat Controller.
Peep, peep, said Edward. I'm ready. Peep, 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 said Henry. So am I. Pull hard, we'll do it. Pull hard, we'll do it. They puff together. We've done it together, we've done it together, said Edward and Henry. You've done it, hooray, you've done it, hooray, sang the coaches. Everyone was excited. The Fat Controller leaned out of the window to wave at Edward and Henry. But the train was going so fast that his hat blew off into a field where a goat ate it for tea. They never stopped till they came to the station at the end of the line. The passengers all said thank you, and the Fat Controller promised Henry a new coat of paint. On their way home, Edward and Henry help Gordon back to the shed. All three engines are now great friends. Henry doesn't mind the rain now. He knows that the best way to keep his paint nice is not to run into tunnels, but to ask his driver to rub him down when the day's work is over.